Hi again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm, and today I want to go with you my software choices, the things that I've chosen to help me to sell plants online. Now, of course, I'm an expert on growing the plants. I have the greenhouses right here behind me, and I've got that part under control. What I've had to do over the past couple of years, though, is I've had to take and turn my effort towards the selling of my plants online. Predominantly now, that's become the main way that I sell my plants, and even more so since the coronavirus has taken over, is that I had to do a lot of my selling for shipping, but I've also had to do my selling for selling it online and then having curbside pickup, no contact pickup here on the farm, and it's worked out great for me. It's kind of nice that more or less I can put my whole inventory online, that people can shop from it, they can see what's available, they can make their orders, and then they can come here and just do a quick pickup, or if they're interested in having a look around on the farm and seeing other plants that they'd like to buy, I can take the same inventory that I've prepared for the online shopping and I can put it onto my Square terminal, my payment processing, and I can have them pay for it here on the farm. So it kind of works really nicely together, but to get it to work nicely like that, I've had to get my head around all these different pieces of software that I have to use and how they interact with each other. So I've kind of thought it useful to break it up into different layers here. And I'm going to share my screen with you here in a minute, but what I wanted to do was have a look at the first bottom layer, which is hosting. And hosting is just so that when people type in www.fraservalleyrosefarm.com and they put that into the address bar of their browser, that it actually goes somewhere, it just doesn't disappear. For that, there has to be somebody who's registered your domain name, and then they hold that routing information on a server somewhere. I don't understand any of that part, but I know you have to pay some money for it. And typically you do have to pay some money for it. It's usually around $15 a month or $20 a month, depending on the service package that you choose. And sometimes you can integrate the hosting into another service. Now, I build my site on WooCommerce, which is a free piece of software, so I have to pay for my hosting separately. But if you had something like Wix or Shopify, one of these sort of integrated, they build your whole site for you and they build the online store, they may take the whole thing and have one price that covers all of those services, including the hosting, and that's a different way of going about it. I've tried to go with something that is more flexible for me and more flexible to the growth of my business, and I think WooCommerce through WordPress is the way to go. So I'm going to talk about those pieces of software in just a second here, but just to say that hosting is a given. The fact that I'm paying for hosting underneath all of this at a rate of about $15 a month, that's my first cost. Second major portion of costs happens in payment processing. So those are the two major things that I'm paying for, and that's currently the overhead of running my software and my online store. So I mentioned there that after the hosting, which is just, you can get that through HostGator or Big HostDaddy or one of those other ones. I probably screwed up the names there, but some of the generic hosting companies, but all of those guys come with the option of automatically installing something called WordPress. Now, WordPress is the next piece of software on that pyramid. It's the it's above the base level. It's the place where you're going to build the overall look and presentation of your website. And I'm going to show you here. I'm going to click through to my dashboard for the website, and you can see here that this is the WordPress dashboard. That's the symbol for WordPress right there. And WordPress is, it started out as a blogging format, but it's very adaptable now. I'm going to go down here to the themes section, because you can actually use the themes to make your website look exactly how you'd like it to be. I'm just going to scroll up and down through here. You can see there's dozens, if not hundreds, of different themes that you can choose from. Some of them are more geared towards a blog style format, some of them are more geared towards e-commerce or that kind of thing. So you can choose whichever one you want, and all you have to do is just pick through these and then input certain information about your website. I'm going to go actually through to the front page of my website here and let you have a look at what mine kind of looks like. It's a very simple layout or format, just has my logo across the top. I've placed some information from one of my videos down a little bit lower, just so if people wanted to see some of the charts that I've released. I have a blog post here about the opening day on the farm for the year. I've got pictures of my roses. And then across the top here, where you see it say shop, I can click through to the online store. This online store is actually a separate plugin to WordPress. So WordPress is that base piece of software that I've authored the look and appearance and themes of my website. Right on top of that, I've placed another piece of software called WooCommerce. And these two, the WordPress and the WooCommerce, happen to be the most used pieces of software, and they're free. Now, I'm going to say free with a big asterisk beside it, because I have to explain that. Everybody has a business model, and they're making money somewhere. From what I can tell, the main way that WordPress and WooCommerce make money is that they offer lots and lots of different paid options. Other things that you can add on, they have sort of an ecosystem. Because they're so widely used, they have kind of an ecosystem of other services that you can add on to make your job a little bit easier in managing both the website and the e-commerce store, and you can pay money for those things. So that's fine. I don't mind that there's somebody making money somewhere. It's just I generally choose the options that cost me the least amount of money. And for both of these, I've been able to get away with my basic setup with no additional charges. So I haven't had to add on any plugins that cost me money on an ongoing basis. Now I want to show you my shop here. I'm going to return to scrolling through here, because you can see it's just a very basic setup. You can choose your category, the roses for local pickup here. And when you click through there, it's going to give you all of the roses that I'm now offering for sale on my farm. And currently, everything is for pickup on the farm. There is a time of the year in the early spring where I offer these, and if you click through to the shipping options, it would give you the option of shipping across Canada. Currently, because all of these are potted into 2-gallon pots, I don't want to ship them, so they're just for local sale and pickup by the customer. But it does have the basics here. If you click through to the item, you're going to see a picture. You may see a brief description, and you can, I kind of erred on the side this year of making my descriptions brief, just because I wanted to get things onto the website very, very quickly. So I have like a vigorous large rambler with clusters of pink through white flowers, once blooming but spectacular. Excellent strong clove scent. That's about as verbose as I've gotten on my descriptions here. And then it has additional details and pictures on the Help Me Find website. I have a link attached here. It has a picture from a contributor on Creative Commons that is available for people to look at. And then it says that I have 3 in stock. They're $25 each. And then you can add to cart. And if you add to cart and you process your payment, then you can arrange to have it picked up on the farm. So that's the basics of it. Very easy. And I'm going to go back to this bar here, and I'm going to say I want to see the dashboard again. So I'm going to show you the back end of this a little bit and how easy it is for you to set all of this up. Again, I'm not going to go into deep detail here, because that'd be a different kind of video, but I just wanted to show you the basics here. Is that, like I said, this is the WordPress dashboard, but on the WordPress dashboard, there's a thing here called WooCommerce, and right underneath the main WooCommerce entry, there's a part that says products. And right now I'm going to say all products, and just show you the back end setup of the products on the site here. And you can see that some of these are not showing up on the online store because they're out of stock. But if you go further down, well, let's have a look at that same rose I was looking on the front page. I'll say Francis and see if something comes up in my search products here. And it does take a second to search. And there it is. I have Francis E. Lester. And in Francis E. Lester, it gives me all the options when I click into the item of, well, you see the same verbiage here, same picture. So you set up your item, and then underneath here, you can tell it how many you have in stock. Now, you're going to see this term now, Square. Square is my payment processor. So next layer up. And I said I'd like to look at this in layers here. So bottom layer, hosting. Second layer was the site building software. That in this case was WordPress. Third layer up is the e-commerce platform, which is WooCommerce. And then the fourth layer up is Square, or my payment processor. Now, I used to use PayPal, and Square is very, very similar in terms of the fees that it charges. I think they're both around 3% of your transaction goes to them instead of you. You know, I'd rather give them nothing, but I guess 3% isn't the worst thing on earth. And what I get for that is I get them handling all of the dispute mechanisms, and I also get the advantage of their software. And what I like about the Square software and why I chose it over PayPal is because then I can have this. And this is my Square register that I use on the farm. So if I have somebody book an appointment to come down to the farm, I've already set up the items in my online store through WooCommerce here, and the items are already in. So if they go shopping through my greenhouse and they find something they want to buy, I can bring this out. I can find the same item on here. I can search it the same way. I can just hit the search thing and I can say Francis, and whoop, there's the plant, and I've added it to my sale, and then I can just hit charge $25, and then it says okay, ready to purchase it. So the nice thing about that is this is talking to this. They're talking to each other. So when I've done that in-person sale, I don't have to go back and update what's on my website. It does it automatically. It shares that information across. What's more, what I kind of like about this is that if I went down to now my Facebook page, and my Facebook page has a way that I can go and preview the shop through a plugin, again, on the back end of, and this is the advantage of using WooCommerce and Square and all these big guys, is that I've made a plugin that automatically takes all of my plants and puts them onto the online store on Facebook. And so now all three of them are talking to each other. If I was sold it, if somebody clicked through Facebook and bought it through my online store, or if I sold it on this register here, it updates the inventory in all of these places, and I don't have to go to three different places to tell each piece of software and update those listings. I don't even have to tell Facebook what I'm selling. It gets that directly from my WooCommerce store. So I'm loving that. I wanted to show you one other thing about Square, and that's this screen here, which is my Square appointments. And it's another service that integrates nicely with Google. So if you go to my Google site here, here it is, you'll see it says book online, right? So book online means that you can go through to your Square, it links it through to the Square back end, and then it actually allows people to book appointments with me. And you can do that through Facebook, you can do that through Google, you can do that directly through Square. And then that service goes directly into my Google Calendar on my phone, and then I know when somebody's coming to see me, and they can cancel or whatever they want to do. I mean, it's a very easy way for me to handle it without taking a bunch of phone calls from customers, without having to handle all of that stuff manually. It just handles it directly through the software. So this is what I'm loving about finding pieces of software that can talk to each other nicely, is that Square talks nicely to Facebook and to Google. Google talks nicely back to them. They all use the same inventory through WooCommerce, which integrates nicely with WordPress. And even if I went into WordPress and I updated the theme and I made my site look completely different, it doesn't matter, because all the other pieces will still know how to talk to WordPress. So I wanted to say one other thing here, which is there is one other beautiful piece of integration that comes through Square here, is you can integrate that with your accounting software. So I use another piece of, you know, free online accounting software called Wave. Now again, Wave is free with the asterisk. It means that you can pay for some services. So when I add payroll, if I hire somebody, then I would pay for that service separately. But the basic accounting software, keeping the books, is free. It comes with that functionality. And so when I sell something on Square, not only does it update all of my inventory and all the other pieces of software, but it takes that revenue that it's depositing into my bank account, and it automatically makes an entry into Wave Accounting, which I love. So I hope this served for you an overview of the kind of advantages you can expect when you choose all of this software and you can get it to work together. I have to say, it wasn't the easiest thing to make it all talk together. There were lots of download steps and updating steps that I had to figure out how to do. But in the end, it's worth it for me to have a bunch of different software that's all serving the purposes of the business, without without having to re-enter the data across a bunch of different pieces of software. I'll leave it at that. If you have any questions or comments, hey, if you're using a different piece of business software that works well for you in your e-commerce, your online store, love to hear about it. If you have questions about this software, happy to take the questions. I'm not an expert, but I have done the basics of setup of this. So definitely feel free to drop that into the comments below the video. Thanks for watching.